Well, hello, all my friends. Welcome back to the channel. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome. My name is T and this is my YouTube channel, Crumpus T and Sewing. Today, I want to share with you all my holiday sewing plans. And these plans include participating in the hashtag Me Made Fashion Show by Talisha and the hashtag Little Red Dress Project by Renata. I'll make sure that I put their links to their channels and also to the videos introducing these challenges in the description box below so you can learn more about these two different challenges. So I really want to focus on the hashtag Me Made Fashion Show this week because my video is due to go live sometime next week. And so I really want to focus on that. And so I'll make sure that I include my thoughts and my plans for focusing on that. It will most likely include one of these two fabrics here. While for the Little Red Dress project, I'm thinking about using this fabric here. But I have patterns here that I want to share with you all and get your thoughts and your ideas on what would look good with these fabrics here. But let's go ahead and start with this Berta pattern. This is the Berta Style 6146. It's a very simple, easy top pattern. You have two different variations. As you can see here, you have view A and you have view B. View A has this little cute neck, this little ruffle on the neck and this necktie. And you also have the variation B where you don't have to put on that ruffle on the neck or that tie. You just have a V-neck here, and then you also have the option for view A to put elastic in the cuff, and then for view B, I believe it's also elastic, but you don't have this little band that you're going to put on the end of the cuff as well. So I think that this is a fun little pattern. It calls for viscose, rayon, lightweight cotton, and silky type fabrics. And I'll show you later on the fabric that I am thinking about using with this. And again, if you guys can chime in below and let me know for my holiday plans what pattern I should use for these fabrics, that would be amazing. I also picked up the Berta 6331, which is also another easy pattern. Now this one is designed for jersey knits, and it has two different variations of a wrap top. You have view A, where you have this cute little flounce at the bottom of the sleeve, and it's just a wrap top that has a tie on the side. And then for view B, you have the option of doing flutter sleeves and then also a flounce around the neckline. And I got this pattern specifically for this version here, and I thought about making a holiday top in a velvet type fabric. And again, I'll show you that here after I finish showing you the rest of the patterns that I have. But I thought that this would be so cute in a velvet fabric, and it will really make a really great holiday top. So again, you all let me know below what your thoughts are on that one. I also picked up the New Look 6707. After I made the patina blouse with that nice little statement collar, I've just been looking at a lot of statement collars lately. I think McCall's put out one, and also Simplicity put out one, and then New Look has this pattern here. And I thought, hey, it's an easy pattern. You have two different variations of a blouse that has buttons down the center front. You have different neckline variation, so you can make the version with the collar or without the collar, and then you also have gathering on the sleeves. So I really like this pattern. I think that it would make for a fun little top. It's easy to make, and yeah, it has 10 pieces and it's just so simple and easy. So I think that this would be really nice to make. Now, one of the things that I have come to find fault with New Look patterns is they have started to go down in their size ranging. So it used to be from 4 to 22 or 4 to 20 or sometimes 6 to 20 or 6 to 22. But lately they have been going down in size. I've seen with their new patterns, with the new covers, a lot of their patterns don't go beyond 18. So I'm really disappointed with that. I hope that that changes in the future, and I hope that this particular pattern will fit me. I'm usually more around that 20 size or the 22, especially for my biceps. So I might have to do some adjustments here, and I'm not happy about that, but I really do like the pattern, and I'm gonna see if it's worth it. The next pattern I picked up is the new look in 6710, which is a pattern that has two different variations. You have a jacket and you also have a skirt. The skirt is a knit skirt and the jacket you can make with fabrics such as suede, ponte, denim, satin, and cotton type fabrics. So it's a really easy pattern and it comes with 8 pattern pieces, which I think would be just simple and easy. The skirt pattern itself is just 2 pieces, and so you have the remaining, I believe, 8 pieces is for the jacket. So it's not, no, let me see, 6 pieces. So the remaining 6 pieces would be for the jacket. So you have 2 pieces for the skirt, 6 pieces for the jacket. I think it's really cute and stylish. And I like the gathering on the sleeve at the bottom. And then I also like that gathering. You have elastic in the back of the jacket as well. So I just think that this is a really cute pattern. Now, I will say from the outset, I went ahead and I took the liberty to open up the pattern. I was going to cut it out last weekend and I was possibly thinking of making a jacket. And I found that this pattern, it's the older version of the new look 6710. So it's not the new look in 6710. I don't know if it's just my copy or if it's all copies that have been distributed. So I will say before you purchase this pattern, make sure you look at the pattern pieces and make sure that you have a jacket and a skirt and not pants and tops. That's what I have in this particular envelope. There are, I think 2 versions of a pair of pants, and then there are tops and things like that. So it's like the older version of the new look 6710. So I was a little bit disappointed by that. I'm gonna have to take this back and switch it out for the actual pattern. So I just thought that I would say that here, just in case any of you are interested. Just make sure you check your pattern and make sure that it's actually the pattern that you see here and not the older version of the new look 6710. So those are the patterns that I picked up for this haul. I didn't do a whole lot of shopping for patterns, so I don't have a huge haul, but I do want to share with you some of my plans for my holiday plans and the fabrics that I have for my holiday plans that's coming up. And hopefully you all will be able to give me some great suggestions and feedback on what I should do with some of these patterns. So I want to go ahead and first start with these 2 patterns here, since they are they have the potential to actually be part of my holiday plans. So for this pattern here, for the Berta style 6146, I thought about making a top with this gorgeous emerald green and black polka dot fabric, which was sponsored to me by Minerva. I've had this for a while now. I really need to get my make done, and I am hoping to make my holiday top and skirt with this. Now, I don't know if I can get a top and a skirt with this, but that is my plan. I'm going to try my hardest to get a top and a skirt. This pattern calls for 1.5 yards of fabric if I make this view here. So I would have about a little over 1.5 yards left. And so I would definitely be able to make a skirt with that if I did that. And so I thought about maybe this pattern here, which is the Berta style 6142, and I would make view A here just because I don't have the fabric for view B, but I would make that. So I thought of making this the set for my holiday plans. Again, I'm not quite for certain yet. The other option I thought about was this here, which is the Butterick B6378. And I thought about this top here. If I make this top, I will not have enough fabric to make a skirt. So that's why I was kind of like on the fence. I don't know if I want to make that, but I do like the idea of having a really nice flowy tie on my top. So that's one of the reasons why I decided to possibly make this. I also thought about the Berta Easy 6155, and I thought about this top here. I really like this little flounce on the bottom of the top. I don't think I would put that little ruffle detail here on it, but I thought about doing this version here. And for that version, for version B, I'm looking at 1.375 yards of fabric. So I definitely would have enough fabric left to make a skirt. So I thought about that as well. I also thought about the Berta Style 6230, which is this cute little blouse here. I thought about this version here that has that tie on the neckline. I really want a tie on my neckline, guys. So I've been trying to search for patterns that have either some type of flounce or a tie on the neckline. I just think that this type of fabric, especially because it's a viscose, it just will look so good with a little necktie or a bow tie or a pussy bow tie. So anyway, I thought about doing this version here, and that's view B. Yeah, that's view B. And that I would need 1 7/8 yards of fabric. So I would have just enough left to make a skirt, just a simple classic skirt with just maybe two pattern pieces, the front and the back, and maybe elastic on the waist. So I think that that could be a possible option as well. Lastly, I thought about the Berta Style 6456. And I thought about this variation here, which is view B. But I would like to put maybe flutter sleeves on this version here. Maybe take this sleeve and spread it out and put flutter sleeves on it, or either a gathered sleeve head or something like that. I think that would be really cute. And for that variation, it's calling for 1 1/2 yards of fabric. But if I add the sleeve, that will probably be another half a yard or so. And so I will be pushing it with this version. I may or may not be able to get a skirt, depending on if I could do maybe color blocking or something like that, then I might would be able to. But I thought about that version as well. I think it would be so classic and so cute for this type of a fabric here. So those are the tops and the plans that I am thinking about for this particular pattern here for the Berta 6331. I thought about using this beautiful scratch velvet fabric. This is a fabric that I purchased from Hobby Lobby, and it does have a nap, so I have to be careful to make sure that I actually cut it out the right way. I used this fabric before, and the first time I participated in the Little Red Dress Project, I made a Berta pattern as well, and it's just a cute little wrap dress. If I can find the picture to that, I'll put it here so you can see what that looks like. But this year I decided that I wanted to make something that had a little bit more of a looser silhouette, especially for my arms. And I thought this with a skirt would be really cute. So having, for instance, this top here with maybe a skirt that's similar to this one here would be really cute as a set for this. I have about 3 1/2 yards of fabric here, and so I can definitely get a top and a skirt. And so that's what I thought about. I also thought about this Berta Style 6443 pattern, which is also a knit pattern, and I thought about this version right here, and I really like this wrap over here and the skirt. I like the flare of the skirt as well, so I thought about this as well. And if I want to make a top, a two-piece, I would make this version here, and then also again a skirt that's similar to this new look pattern here. So I haven't decided if I want to make the dress or if I want to make a two-piece with this, but you guys chime in below, let me know what you think would be the best suitable option for these here. I forgot to also include this pattern here, and I wanted to go ahead and tell you a little bit about this pattern because I did purchase this pattern, and it's part of this pattern haul. It's the Butterick B6860, and this pattern comes in plus sizes as well as regular sizes, and so I really like this pattern here. So you can get it in sizes 8 to 16 or 18W to 24W. I purchased this pattern specifically for this wrap dress here, and this could also be another option for this red velvet stretch fabric here, because the pattern calls for jersey interlock type fabrics, and so this is a stretch fabric. Let me know below if you think that that would be cute for a velvet skirt. Lastly, I want to make something with this beautiful cotton sateen shirting fabric. It is a 100% cotton fabric that is peacock green and navy, and I have 4 yards of this. So I have quite a bit of fabric here. I can do quite a lot with this. So I thought about the Rose Claire dress, and I just recently made that. I'll put a link here as an iCart so you can see what that looks like. But I made a beautiful wrap tier dress out of the strawberry and navy version that Fabric Mart carry. And I really liked that color so much that I decided to get this one as well. I love the fabric, but you can all see my review of the fabric and the Rose Claire dress. I'll go ahead and put that link here, like I said. Now, I thought about doing view A, and that's the view that is not tiered. So it's a regular wrap dress. And I thought about doing that, but even if I did that, I would still have a little bit of fabric left over. And if I decided to do the Rose Claire dress with this fabric here, I would also make this top here, which is the new look in 6707. I think this is a really great top pattern to go with this particular fabric. So I thought about doing that. If I decided not to do the Rose Claire dress, I would definitely make this top. And then I have some options of skirts that I would actually make as well. So let's start with this one here. This is the Simplicity S9109. This is a skirt pattern that I just recently sewed for Minerva Make. And I used a viscose rayon fabric. It's very drapey. I love that skirt, and I love the drape of the skirt. You'll see the review of this pattern pretty soon, and you'll get to see the skirt and the set that I made for my Minerva Make. But I definitely would like to make this in a cotton, and I thought that this peacock green would be just perfect for that. So I think these two as a set would look really well together. And so I thought about doing a skirt and a top if I don't make the Rose Claire dress. But even if I make the Rose Claire dress, I'll still have enough to make the top, but I won't have enough to make a top and a skirt. So it's either the Rose Claire dress with this top or make these two here, but I haven't decided quite yet. The other skirt pattern I decided on is the Butterick B6773. I've been wanting to make this for about a year and a half now, and I haven't made it yet. If I were to make this pattern, I would make view B. As you can see, this pattern comes in two different variations. You can make view A. You have buttons going down the front of the garment. So this is more of an asymmetrical style in the front here. But you also have this cute flounce, which I think is just so gorgeous. And you have this waistband that you have on the garment as well. Now, I would choose this version here because it has a wrap. It has a tie here for the wrap. Even though this is a wrap skirt as well, you have ties for the wrap. And I like the idea of just having this as a complete wrap instead of having buttons on the center. And it also has this beautiful flounce as well. So I think that that would also be really nice together. I think that would be a cute set. But again, you let me know below your thoughts on this. The last skirt pattern that I thought about making is this Berta Style 6235. This is a pattern that also has two different variations. View A has this really wide waistband. I don't think that I would actually make this version. I think I would make this one that has the slimmer waistband. You have slanted pockets. As you can see, you have a center front seam, and you have the option of making a tie belt as well. So I really like that option as well. So I think that I would definitely make this variation here. You also have these belt loops on it as well. So I would probably make this version here. I think it's really simple and easy, and I like the styling of that one a little bit more. This one calls for cotton fabrics, also lightweight fabrics, wool blends and things like that. So I would definitely make this version here for that. So those are the plans that I am thinking about for this particular make, and also for the rest of the holiday fabrics that I showed you in this video. I am clueless as to what I really want to do. I would be so grateful to get any kind of direction, suggestions, recommendations from you all. You all give some really great advice and some good recommendations. A lot of my garments, the things that I put together, are from your recommendations. So I love to hear from you. I love to hear from you, and I would like to hear exactly your thoughts and things on this. But yeah, so that's everything that I have to share today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure that you give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel if you like my content. And I hope you all have a blessed and happy Saturday. Until next time, stay creative. Bye.